Assalamu alaikum. We are discussing about assessment and management of syphilis. What is syphilis? It is a chronic infection caused by Treponema pallidum. The incubation period of syphilis is 2 to 6 weeks. Transmission. Syphilis is transmitted by sexual contact or transplacental route or through blood transfusion or organ transplantation. Pathogenesis. Treponema pallidum penetrates the skin or mucous membrane or microscopic abrasion in skin. Within a few hours, the organism enters the blood and lymphatics. The primary infection appears at the site of inoculation, usually persist for 4 to 6 weeks, then heal spontaneously. Perivascular infiltration of T lymphocyte, plasma cell or macrophage. There is capillary endothelial proliferation. Phagocytosis of opsonized organism leads to resolution of chancre. This is a flow chart of syphilis from inoculation of organism into the body through clinical manifestation. At first, the organism enters into the body, then there may be primary syphilis which may progress to secondary syphilis. Primary syphilis is characterized by chancre, regional lymphadenopathy, and secondary syphilis is characterized by maculopapular rash, fever, lymphadenopathy, mucous patch, alopecia, hepatitis, nephritis. But sometime after primary infection, there may be latent phase, which may be early latent, may be late latent. Both early and late latent are asymptomatic. If latent phase occur within 1 year of infection, it is called early latent, and if it occurs more than 1 year of infection, it is called late latent. Late latent phase may progress to lifetime latency or tertiary syphilis. Lifetime latency is asymptomatic, and tertiary syphilis may progress to granulomatous disease, cardiovascular syphilis, ocular syphilis, otic syphilis, and meningovascular syphilis, meningomyelitis, general paralysis of insane or tabes dorsalis. But sometime after inoculating into the body, the organism may progress to CNS invasion before primary infection, before secondary infection, before latent phase. At first, after embedding into the mucous membrane or skin, at first it may be present with CNS invasion in the form of early neurosyphilis, which may be asymptomatic, may be symptomatic in the form of meningeal syphilis or meningovascular syphilis. There may be ocular syphilis or otic syphilis. This asymptomatic syphilis may lead to late neurosyphilis. Now, primary syphilis. Primary syphilis is characterized by maculopapular rash, which may progress to indurated ulcer, that is chancre. It is characterized by discrete, rubbery, mobile, painless, non-tender lymphadenopathy. Without treatment, the chancre resolves within 2 to 6 weeks. This is a chancre in the glans penis. Secondary syphilis occurs 6 to 8 weeks after development of chancre. Characterized by constitutional feature such as fever, myalgia, body ache, loss of appetite. There may be maculopapular rash at the trunk, limb, palm or sole. Generalized non-tender lymphadenopathy. Maculopapular rash involving the plantar aspect of right foot. Condylomata lata, papule coalescing to plaque, usually occur at warm, moist site such as uvula, vulva, perianal area. So, condylomata later is characterized by papule coalescing to plaque. Mucus patch is characterized by a lesion in the mucus surface, usually affecting the mouth, larynx or pharynx. May involve different organ in the form of meningitis, cranial nerve palsy, uveitis, hepatitis, gastritis. Tertiary syphilis develop after 3 to 10 years after infection. It is characterized by gamma, tissue paper scar, punched out ulcer. Gamma is characterized by granulomatous inflammatory lesion with central area of necrosis due to endarteritis obliterans, involving the tongue, healing of which lead to leukoplakia with the risk of malignant change. So, gamma is a pre-malignant condition. Remember this. Gamma is a pre-malignant condition which is a granulomatous inflammatory lesion with central area of necrosis due to endarteritis obliterans. I have repeated. Cardiovascular syphilis. Inflammation of vasa vasorum of ascending aorta. Manifestation usually appear after 10 to 40 years after infection. Clinical features include aortic incompetence, aortic aneurysm, and angina. Investigation, VDRL test may be positive, which may be false positive in infectious mononucleosis, chickenpox, malaria, pregnancy, and other autoimmune disease. There may be false negative report, which may occur in secondary syphilis because high antibody titer may prevent the formation of antigen antibody latex. Chest X-ray, ECG, echo are done to exclude cardiovascular syphilis. TPSA, dark field microscopy, PCR can be done. Now management. Early syphilis is treated with injection benzathine penicillin 2.4 million unit intramuscular only for single dose. But if injection safe traction is given, it is given in the dose of 2 gram daily for 10 days. But late syphilis is treated for more duration, more prolonged or longer duration. If benzathine penicillin is given, it is given in the dose of 2.4 million unit intramuscular weekly for 3 weeks. But if injection safe traction is given, it is given in the form of 2 gram daily for 14 days. So, thank you all. Thanks for hearing this video.